So hi everyone, we are from group A. We like to present about Erysipelas in pigs. So basically, the causative agent for this disease is Erysipelas roseopathiae. So it is a gram-positive bacteria with rock shape and non-spore-forming, non-acid fast, non-mobile bacterium, catalase negative. And the route of entry is through oral route or through cut or wound. Next. Okay, next, for the mode of transmission, actually these are the host will eliminate the agent in the process. So, the first one is the ingestion of organism, which is the host or the organism will ingest the Erysipelas in the soil or slurry. The second transmission is the contact of wound, which is when the animal has open wound, so the agent in the urine assists the direct contact with the open wound so that the agent will directly enter the bloodstream. And the last one is carried by the white bird or white bird and other mammals, which is they will carry the agent and will directly secreted in the drink or feed so that the agent will enter the body of the infected animals. Next, for diagnosis.
For diagnosis, first we will ask for the history, whether there are fungal outbreaks and the management of the fungus. And second, we will look at the clinical signs such as diamond vision, high temperature, blotching of skin and ear, reluctant to move, abortion, and infertility in boars. The diamond vision and abortion is usually related to the vegetative endocarditis and acute septicemia caused by the bacteria. Because of the high fever, it could also lead to high fever and abortion of the fetus. And the vegetative endocarditis leads to the formation of emboli that will lodge into the blood vessel. If it lodges into the uterine artery, it will lead to the abortion. And if it and the diamond vision, it forms when the emboli lodge into the smaller capillaries on the skin and make the area become ischemic and produce the vision. For lab diagnosis, we usually use blood and organ culture since the bacteria is present in the blood. For the culture, usually it's for 48 hours. If it is longer than that, the older colonies could lose their more integrity and it would appear as gram negative instead of positive. For serology, we will use agglutination tests for chronic infection. Next, we move on to prevention.
So for the prevention, there are three methods here. The first one is vaccination. Vaccination is usually done on the weak piglets and geared themselves before service, and the immunity is usually lasts for 6 months. For management, cleaning and disinfectation is really important in maintaining the hygiene of the pens, and the pigs who are having the clinical signs need to be eliminated to prevent the spreading of the Erysipelas. Thank you.
So I'll now pass my mic to Sandari.
I'll talk about the control for Erysipelas in pigs. One control method is good nutrition and housing, and also the quality of new arrival. We need to house the pigs in appropriate amounts in each pen to prevent the transmission of the disease. Besides that, when new pigs arrive from other farms or from outside, or when we buy new pigs, we need to quarantine them from our current pig population to prevent the spread of this disease and also other diseases. I'll pass to Lindsay.
So the last control for the Erysipelas is
proper carcass exposure, which is through burial of the carcass of the pigs or the incineration of the carcass of the pigs. So that is all from us. Thank you.
Thank you.